Hey, this is Allison from Mahalo Math. Welcome to our SAT prep series. We're going to be working some problems, and working with me today is Chrissy and Trevor. So let's get started. All right, problem 26. Three business partners are to share profits of $24,000 in the ratio 5:4:3. What is the amount of the least share? Okay, so what do we know? Let's just start there.
There's $24,000.
There's $24,000 total, exactly.
And it's being divided between three.
It's being divided between three and in a ratio of 5:4:3.
Now, the 5:4:3, are those, does that make a percentage or a part?
Parts, exactly, okay. Right. So how many parts total do we have then?
12.
Yes, how did you get 12?
I just added them up.
Yes, you add the individual parts, so 5 + 4 + 3 is equal to 12. So we have 12 parts that this is going to be split into. Mm-hmm. So how much is one part then? How much money? We have $24,000 altogether and 12 parts. So what is one part?
One part is $2,000.
Yeah, how did you get it?
I took 24,000 and I divided that by 12.
Exactly. Okay, so we know that one part is $2,000. What was the question that they asked us?
The question is the amount of the least share.
So who gets the least share in this partnership?
The individual represented by the three.
So how much money does that person get? If one portion of this is $2,000 and you're getting three shares, how much money do you get?
That partner would get $6,000. Mm-hmm. Because three times 2,000.
Three times 2,000. Two, exactly. Three times 2,000 would give us 6,000.
I had no idea that was that easy to solve.
Yeah, it's really not. All you have to know is that when they give you a ratio like that, 5:4:3, mm-hmm. that those are the parts of the whole. In this case, our whole thing is basically split into 12 parts. That way you can find out how much one part would be, and if you're entitled to three parts, you multiply it by three. If you're entitled to four parts, you'd multiply it by four. So the person who's getting five parts, how much money do they get?
They would get $10,000?
They would get $10,000, right. They would get they would get five times $2,000. Mm-hmm. Five shares times $2,000 a share.
Now, because I was just looking at it, if I could, make this as 12 as close to 100%, and without doing the math, because I didn't know how to do it that
way. Right.
If I was going to infer and try and say that I knew that it was probably 6,000 or 3,000.
Okay.
Would you say that that's a good way to go about problems if you don't know how to do the equation?
If you absolutely have no idea, you just look at this and you're just completely stumped. Mm-hmm. But you feel like you can confidently take out one or two possible answers, then it's worth making an educated guess then if you can at least eliminate something. And I mean, that's better than if you just have no idea. Sometimes you just have no idea. So, absolutely, if you felt like really pretty confident that it was either 3,000 or 6,000, it would have been worth a shot. And you had a 50% chance of getting it right, because 6,000 was right. So yes, definitely. That's always a strategy if you get stuck.
Okay, great. Thanks.
Yeah, sure. Thanks for learning with us today. If you'd like any more information on these topics, click on the links below. And if you have a specific request, please send it to requests@mahalo.com. We'll see you later.